Hey, this is Papa from StreetFighterTrainingSystem.com. All right, so today I want to do a Papa review that will be a little bit different because I will go into details on how I find the setups, right? After that it happened, so hindsight, I will say. And I also want to talk about something very important. So I'll spend 2 minutes before because yesterday I was looking at the market live. And looking at the Discord, and I'm a little bit worried on how people are managing risk and willing to take trades, right? So I want to spend like 3 minutes maybe to talk about money management, okay, and risk because nowadays I think yesterday and today the risk on the ES is very, very, very high, meaning that to enter a candle, right, you need to take a risk of 5 points or 6 points to be able to take the trade. So your risk will be six and your reward probably one and so on, right? So I want to tell you how I would approach this and what is my mindset on this. Okay, so first thing is if you go on the part one lesson, right, you will see that among all the lesson, so lesson 18, lesson 8, I talk about money management, most important lesson. Because in reality, guys, the setup, we don't care. The psychology, we don't really care in reality. The most important part in trading is actually how you're gonna manage your money and how you're gonna do to cut down your loss, right? Short, to have small loss but big wins, okay? And the reality is that even if you play randomly, you know what? You will be able to win on the market. And maybe to prove it, I will create like a series maybe next month, where I will take random trades, right? But I will have a risk to reward. So a risk of one for a reward of two. And it will show you that I will still be able to be winner on the market. Anyway, so I want to show you the scenario. So I don't know if you remember on this video, I had like an Excel sheet. And then I showed you that for scalping, so doing a show you trade and show you punish. The reward risk, because it's scalping, is a little bit different, right? So we are willing to win one and to lose two, okay? And this is already quite tough to handle, but anyway, let's say. So this was showing you that if you have like a 70% rate, you can be positive, right? But positive, still, are you really willing to play to make $34 per month? Right, I'm not so sure. Anyway, so what you should be achieving is 90% plus, and here the amount starts to be decent, right? Which is $600, which is quite good, right? But let's say, okay, that you are willing to take 6 point loss, right, to win 1 point. You can see that here it forces yourself to do almost zero mistakes. Right, so it's very, 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 very tough. And even at 90%, you're at $200, right? So my advice, don't listen to whatever people will tell you. I think that when you trade, you need to have a game plan, and you shouldn't change your game plan. You shouldn't say, okay, before I used to take one reward for two risks, and now I'm gonna change my plan because the market is volatile and I need to change it. Or even, I know some people, what they say is, if I take a risk of 1.5, then I can allow myself to, so let's say a risk of 3, then I can take 1.5 reward, right? So don't do this. Don't do this because the problem is that you wouldn't have backtested this, right? The idea is to have a single game plan, to backtest it over and over again, okay? And you know that if you do this, right, over and over, what you have to do is to have at least a rate of 70%, right? If you start changing your risk to reward, so sometimes you will do like 1.5 and then 3, but you don't know if the market is going to touch your 1.5, right? So yes, your probability would be similar, but you don't know what will happen, right? So when you have a game plan, don't change it. It's like, for me, it's the number one mistakes of beginner, like changing their game plan and trying to optimize, like trying with 1 day to prove that theory works, and then on the very next days it's not going to work anymore. Okay, so don't change it. Second thing that I want to say is same for your strategy, right? If you say that you need a good candlestick, right, to go on a trade, it's not because the market is volatile that you need to change your rules and say, ah, finally, the market is volatile. I'm going to take trades on candles that are bullish and go short. Right? You shouldn't do this. Don't do this. Stick to the rules, and I guarantee that you will be winner on the long run. So I have three advice when the market is behaving like it behaves on the past 2 days. Okay? So what you can do. So let's say you are playing the 2K tick chart, right? So the first thing that you can do is you can lower the time frame. Because if you lower the time frame, okay, you will be able to have candles that are smaller. Okay, so you can find setups on smaller time frame with candles that are smaller, so your risk will be less. Okay, so this is the first thing. Second choice is that you can still keep playing your two-legged pullback and failed two-legged pullback, but still keep your 2 point loss and one reward. So if it hits, it hits, right? But then, basically it's not following the rule. And third, which what I will personally do is that I will simply not trade, right? I will simply not trade. It's okay to have one day where you don't trade and you just look at the market, right? Most of the time, the market is not going to behave like this. That means you're not going to have candles of 6 point, 5 point, 10 point big. Most of the time it's going to be 2 point, right? So I guess that sometimes you're better off doing nothing and just looking at your screen and come back another day if you want to be a winner in the long run. Okay. So with all that said, now let's go to the review. So for this review, exceptionally, I will go on the 2K tick chart. Because I know that everybody is using this thing, so I want to help you guys, and I want to show you basically step by step what I will do to train myself and to see hindsight first what are the good setup and what are the bad setups, right? So let's get into this. So what I want to do is the day starts at 8:30. Right, so what happened is, again, when you want to train yourself is simply, but you need to apply all the rules, right? So you start looking by where is the trend, is it a good candle, draw your short-term trend lines if you can, and so on, right? So we're going to start the day, and we see that first we had an impulsive move to the upside, so I can draw my short-term trend line. For those who don't choose the 50 SMA, let's say, you draw your short-term trend line, you see that it's upward, so you're looking for a two-legged move to the down that breaks the short-term trend line first, and is what you have, right? So the idea now is to ask yourself, can you take this trade, right? So I let you like 10 seconds, and I'm going to zoom up. Can you take this trade to the long side? Well, the answer is no. Why? So for several reasons. First reason is that you have an opposing short-term trend line, right, that is acting as resistance, right? So if you have an opposing, often it's a bad idea to go long because it will go on top and then reverse, okay? So of course the trade works, right? It doesn't mean that the trade will not work. You never know. You never know if it's going to work or not. But what you are playing is probabilities, okay? And the probability say is that if you have an opposing short-term trend line, and if it breaks, then you have a higher chance that it's going to go lower and not higher, okay? So this was the first reason. Second reason is that this candle is a doji, right? Third reason is that the candle is below the EMA. So this makes that it's not a good trade. All right, so first trade that we wouldn't have taken. Okay, so I'm gonna mark it as blue. Then on the next, we have a Shoryu punish, right? So we have up, down. So can you take this? Well, the answer is always you do your checklist and you check if all the parameters are there. So one parameter that I like to have on Shoryu Punish is the Fibonacci, okay? So we can see that it retraced to the Fib level. The candle for me is fucked up, and that's the reason why I will not go in this trade, because for me this is kind of a dodgy, right? But I think it's an aggressive trade to take. It has all the parameters apart from the candle, right? So it's okay to take this, but personally I wouldn't take it, right? Then you have a short-term trend line to the downside like this, right? So you're looking to short, of course. Do you have a two-legged move? You don't, right? Then you continue on the market. You have a short-term trend line over here, right? And then you have a two-legged move, right? So up, down, up. So it's a show you trade. Can you take this? So at the moment at which it happened, right, you would have seen this candle and you're looking at a buy stop below this candle. So the answer is no, the candle is not good. It's the same as this part, which is for me a doji, right? But then the next candle breaks one tick lower. So now the setup becomes interesting, right? And because first it breaks the high of the candle and it breaks the low of the candle. So it becomes like an outside bar, okay? So even though this candle was shit, now the setup becomes interesting because we have an outside bar and the risk is 2 points, right? So what I would do personally, for me, it's a good trade to take, and so I would take it, but I will not place my buy stop below this low. I will put a limit order over here, right? So if the price come back over here, I will get filled. If it goes without me, I will not get filled, right? So this is what I would do. I will place like a buy stop, right, over here. Enfin, a stop sell, sorry, over here. So you see that the price come back and we would have got filled, right? So now we are in the trade and we are able to get our 1 point for 2 point risk. So 1 point reward for 2 point risk, right? And it was a pretty good trade. So this one, definitely, you could have taken it. And it's a very good, good trade, okay? So next one, so you draw of course your short-term trend line. So you don't need to draw your short-term trend line if you're using the SMA, right? The SMA and EMA now should tell you which direction it is, but I know that still some people are not using the SMA, so it's fine to draw the short-term trend line just to understand which direction should you play. Should you play the short or should you play long? Okay, so yeah, when the short-term trend line is going downwards, you want to find for opportunities on the short side, right? And again, I repeat, for those who haven't looked at a video that I've done, is what you want is to have a short-term trend line break, okay? And what you are playing is when there is a short-term trend line break, the probability that it does lower than this one is higher. And this is what you are searching for. You are searching for a probability of low, right, is lower than this. So you need to have room of 1 point between the entry point and at least the low of this candle. Okay, so here you cannot take for trade. So there is there a two-legged move? So up, down, it doesn't redo up, so it's only a one-legged move, okay? And then starting from here, right, so you have up, down, up. Again, show you. Wait, I know. So sorry, the show you happens here, right? So here you have this, down, up. The candle is a doji, so you cannot go over here, right? So this trade over here, you cannot take it. And then past this, me, I wouldn't take any trade because you are too late on the party, right? You already have like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 impulse, right? So I know that people are still willing to search for opportunities even after 5 impulse. So my answer is after 2 retrace, right? Just don't look at any trades, right? Because the probability that it goes lower, right, is very, very low, okay? So of course it can go lower, right? It can go lower and it's what it does. So, and specifically when there is a dump on the market, it will go lower. But again, what are you guys playing? Are you guys going into the casino to play your money and lose, or are you playing the probabilities? personally, I'm playing the probabilities, right? So I wouldn't go short after a certain period of time, right? So, and the period of time is 2 iterations, as I teach you guys, okay? So anyway, so as the move goes up, then some people, as I say, they will still try to short over here, even though they are already too late to the party, right? So what they will do is they see a short-term trend line over here, right? And then it does up, down, up, even though now, okay, actually the short-term trend line is going up, so you should be looking for long opportunities, right? But I know that some people will look at the short opportunities. So let's talk about this first. So can you go over here? The answer is no, right? But first, because the candle is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points risk, right? And as I say to you, you don't want to take a trade with 5 point risk. But this candle is bullish, you cannot. Some people will also, they will try to take the lower high over here, but again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 point risk, okay, for one reward. You cannot take those type of trade, you cannot, and it's too late to the party, and in any case. So yeah, again, you don't need to listen to me, right? But if you do, I think I will save you like 2 years of learning process to stay out of the market when this happened, right? And you would have already got a good trade over here. This was a 2 risk point, and you see on the runner, if you had a runner, you would really, really be in a good situation, right? Anyway, so so then I want to talk about this. So me, when I look at this, actually I will not be looking for short, right? As I said, I would draw my short-term trend line, right? And here you see that the short-term trend line is going upwards. So here you see, you are looking for a break of the short-term trend line, right? And then what you are looking at is maybe to go long, right? But again, why you cannot go long? But because you are below EMA. If you have the SMA, it's hanging down, so you cannot go, but yeah, it would have worked, right? But see, actually, this is the perfect example of a trap, right? So it goes higher, and here you have a trap, and people would have taken, as I said, this because number one, they saw a low high and they saw a trap. But again, can you really go on a candle of 5 point risk? Well, me personally, I will never do it. What I would do though is, as I said, I let you 3 choices. First choice is you go in, but then your risk is only 2 points, right? And on this case, you would have got filled and you wouldn't have got stopped out because it's 4 points, right? So yeah, it's 1, 2, and your 2 would have been above over here. So this trade could have been tradable only and only if, right, you keep the same risk to reward ratio. Okay, so I authorize you to take this, but only if you keep the same risk to reward ratio, or if you go on a lower time frame, or you should just don't take it. Okay, so those are the 3 choices. So this, as I say, you can maybe take it, but then your risk to reward has to be 2 points for one reward. Okay, so up, it makes you 2 trades that worked. Over here, so cannot take. So what people will do? Yeah, maybe people will try to take. No, I don't think so. So then we have a reverse move, right? So it does how to call it? Upward short-term trend line. We have down, up, down. So show you trade. Can we take this? The answer is no. Why? Always for the same reason, because the candle is not good enough, right? So it's a doji bar. You don't really know which direction it will go. But again, this thing actually it does an evening star. So after this break, then you can place a limit order, right? But if you look only at this candle, it's not good. Okay, so I will show you some other techniques where you can enter this combination of candle. I haven't done the video yet. So it was the case, I think, for which one already? No, I don't remember. Anyway, so let's continue. This cannot take it. You draw your short-term trend line going upwards, so you're trying to see a break. There is no break that does a two-legged move. Here, there is one. So, why? So, yeah. Yeah, you can draw again your short-term trend line like this. It does a down, up, down. Can you take this? Maybe, right? This candle is between bearish and bullish. Me, I don't like it, but some will consider it as good. But again, the candle is 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 point risk, right? So definitely, I will not take it. And if you would have taken it with a four, so 2 points risk and 1 point reward, so I guess it opened here, it closes here, so you would have won, right? You would have won. So this, maybe you can take it, but again, with a risk of two for a reward of one. Okay, so then we continue. Can you take this one? No, right? So I'm not going to do it all. Yeah, I don't see anything interesting. Short. No, no two-legged move. So here again. So can you take this two-legged move? The answer is no. Why? The candle is bullish. Even if you look at this, right, candle, it's one, two, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 points of risk. Okay, so are you willing to take 6 points of risk? Me no, but up to you guys. So again, another trade. So you had a lot of two-legged pullback, right? And all of them actually worked, right? Candle, not candle, with the trend, not with the trend. All of them, you could have taken them. But again, for me, you should not construct bad habits on trying to take trades that don't follow all the rules. You need to have all the rules if you want to take trades, okay? I continue. I don't see anything over here. Yeah, no. Here it's puking to the downside, right? You have a huge drop, and people will still try to take like short after this impulse. So first impulse, second impulse, they will try to go on this one, and so on, right? So, honestly, don't do it. Okay, so I think that's pretty much what I've seen, what I wanted to share. Maybe one last trade that I would have taken, okay, is basically a Pikachu that happened over here with a good candlestick just before 2 a.m. So we have up, down, right? And we have a down, up, down. Right, so on this, the candle is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 point risk. So of course you are not going to place a buy stop order and put your stop limit over here to get 1 point, right? That would be ridiculous. But if so it has everything. I think it even has like the Fibonacci. Let's check it out. As I said, on failed to get pullback. So yeah, retrace, it pierced the 61.8 comeback. So I would have taken this, but again, what would have been my risk to reward ratio? So 2 points for one reward. Okay, so if we enter here, the candle never breaks over here, so go down 2 points lower, so it's fine, right? And we would have won this one. Okay, so if we resume the day, there was, I think, three trades that we could have taken. The first one was at the beginning of the session, right, which was early in the trend, Good two-legged move, and then you have a huge runner, right? If you are playing runner, second one would have been this failed two-legged pullback. Again, the risk is quite high, but if you have a 2-2-1, it's okay. And then the last one is this one, which is a Pikachu, right? Pikachu. Pretty good for 1 point cap, so three trades. Anyway, this video, I think it's quite long, but what I want to emphasize is if you are a beginner, right, don't even try to trade live. What you do, right, is you go into several days, so you load, you go on your chart, on your data series, okay? You can go for free. I think NinjaTrader gives for free replay data or past data. You load like 10 days, you go into, on the trading hour, you put CME US Index Future ETH. If you are playing the 2000 tick chart, put 2000 tick. You have your SMA, EMA, and then what you try is to just find in hindsight, okay, all the moves. And then what you do is on all the moves, you try to basically understand, is it a good move or not? And would you have taken it? So you mark them, yes, I've taken this. I would have taken this. No, I wouldn't have taken this. Yes, I would have taken this. Yes, no. So this will build like muscle memory in your mind so that when you go live, you will be more confident to take those trades, okay? And again, I emphasize before I cut the video, don't change your risk to reward. This is crazy. The only thing that you will win is to burn your account in the future, right? So have a trading plan. Your trading plan should always be the same. Stick to it. If you play good candlestick, bond CMA and whatever, don't change it along the way. Don't change your risk to reward along the way because the market is changing condition, right? You backtest something for several days and then you see if it works. If it works, you go on it with the market. But it's not like you come on one day and you say, oh, finally, maybe I should change it from two risk to a six risk. No, don't do this. Okay. Anyway, this was Papa from StreetFighterTrainingSystem.com. Post on the comment section if you disagree with me. I would be happy to understand your point of view. Bye.